Now, to present the Ian McClellan Hunter Award for Lifetime Achievement, celebrated actor and star of Ryan's Hope and Star Trek Voyager, Kate Mulgrew.
Thank you very much. There is no one I would rather stand up in front of a room full of strangers and praise than Claire Labine. I could do it in any room, anywhere, and at any time, and I would always do it well. It is impossible to disappoint when speaking of someone like Claire, for the simple reason that there is no one else like her. I've met a lot of people, and I've loved a few, but I've never met anyone remotely like Claire Labine, and I have never loved another friend in the extraordinary way that I love Claire. Claire wanted to be an actress, and although very pretty, she was tall and imposing and unmistakably smart, very smart. And just under this intelligence, there was a sensitivity, a courage, and an understanding of people that soon led her to her essential gift as a writer. She cut her teeth on children's television, and not long after was offered her first writing job on the soap opera, Where the Heart Is. She went from script writer to head writer within a year, and her skills were so impressive that she and her writing partner, Paul Mayer, were asked to create an original daytime serial. That show was called Ryan's Hope. Yes, you can applaud. And when it aired in 1975, it not only changed the way people thought about soap operas, it changed the definition of soap operas. Claire wrote a story about an Irish-American family who owned a bar in New York. She wrote about their struggles, their triumphs, their failures, their loves, and of course, their enemies. But she did it in a way that had everyone rooting for their goodness, which was something that hadn't been seen before on daytime. And she went boldly where no soap opera creator had gone before. She delved into politics, religion, loyalty, marriage, betrayal, and grief. All of these themes she endowed with truth and grace and guts, and her pen was as elegant and powerful as a missile. I should know. She plucked me from obscurity and sent me soaring when she asked me to play her heroine, Mary Ryan, a role that after 40 years in show business is still my calling card. Claire didn't just have a knack, she had genius, and everyone on Ryan's Hope knew it. Claire won 3 Emmys for Ryan's Hope, and during my tenure wrote a beautiful movie called Love Spell, based on the epic tragedy of Tristan and Isolde, starring Richard Burton, and I got to play his wife. God is good, but Claire was better. After Ryan's Hope, Claire made her mark on other shows, and she continued to break new ground. As head writer for General Hospital, she wrote a story about AIDS when AIDS was not discussed. And in so doing, she forced her audience to listen and to learn. Claire asked her audience to rise to the occasion, and they did, not only because they were riveted by the material, but because they were elevated by it. She won 2 Emmys for General Hospital. Whenever I went to Claire's house in Brooklyn for dinner, I'd nip down to the study and count the statuettes, and invariably I'd find a newcomer. Emmys, Writers Guild Awards, a Lifetime Achievement Award for Natus. The walls were lined with accomplishment. But Claire's greatest accomplishment was upstairs, at the table. And their names are Matthew, Eleanor, and John. All 3 of Claire's children are artists, and like their mother, exceptionally gifted. Claire lives down the street from me now, on the Upper West Side, and we often meet and have dinner and our do of liquids. I know she's working on a play about Sappho because, of course, I want to play it. A few weeks ago, I begged her to read me just the first act, and when she had finished, I just sat there, stunned. It has never been better, this gift of hers, never more moving or more completely alive. So that's it then, when you're talking about my friend Claire Labine. She is an original, and originals don't get older, they get better. Let's take a look at just a few moments from Claire's incredible career.